I'm a Lego inventor, and today I'm gonna design and test 6 Lego gadgets to see which ones are actually useful and which ones aren't even worth making. This may be a bad idea. All right, so the first idea I have is a Lego wrist-mounted shooter, and it'll also have a built-in laser. Should be pretty easy to make. We're just gonna need a strap and then a little piece on top. For the laser, we're just gonna use this generic cat laser. Guys, make sure not to shine this in your eyes. It could cause permanent damage.
Danger.
Take all the pieces apart. We're going to clip the 2 connectors. So now we have a positive and a negative. So then we're gonna take the batteries out of this and tape them together so that we don't need this whole assembly. They all stay together like that. And then we can take this, put the red on the positive side and the blue on that side, push the button. So now we got the laser. Now we gotta pick a shooting piece that actually fires. This. Honestly, the best choice here is this thing that's modified. Okay, so now we got our laser. Look at this. This is all that's going on top of this. We need to build a Lego strap that'll go around our hand so that we can actually mount something to the top of it. And bend. If we have 2 rows of these, we should be able to make a good wrist thing.
Perfect.
And then if we just grab some tiles. Look at that. Now we have a, you know, watch. Guys, I just want you to know that this will help you survive if you ever find like a spider on the wall. Use the laser to aim and then shoot the missile. It could save your life. Probably. Come to think of it, I could have just used one of these bracelets Lego actually makes because it's comfortable. And wow, that would have been a lot better. You're welcome to use one of these too. Same concept. We're gonna leave these 2 studs open and then we can just put a plate on top. We want to have this installed in here and the laser right here. And then we can put the batteries right there. Here's what we got. We got our little missile right here. Little missile. All you have to do is push down the laser by just doing that. It's looking super cool so far. Let's see what we can do. Gotta aim a little to the left. Hey. Let's go. This thing is actually super cool. The fact that it has a laser sight and you can just aim it at what you actually want to shoot. This thing's awesome, guys. I'd say this is an accurate tool and it's really fun. Don't shoot it at your eyes. Definitely don't shoot the laser at your eyes. Let's move on to the next thing. Stop right there because this video is sponsored by Keeps. Keeps is a subscription service that offers doctor-recommended, clinically proven treatments to help combat the symptoms of hair loss and help men keep their hair. See these 3 Lego minifigures? 2 of them are going to experience some form of male pattern baldness before they're 35. Just like real men. Luckily, Keeps is here to help fight hair loss. And I don't know about you, but I like my hair. Imagine me bald. We'd have to call it bald science. Keeps not only offers treatment plans at around half the cost of what you'd pay at the pharmacy, but they make it super easy to save your fine follicles by delivering personalized treatments straight to your door. So you can combat the symptoms of hair loss without ever visiting a doctor's office. Which is honestly great because I don't like doctor's offices, and I don't think I've ever met a single person who does. Or a person in a relationship who does. With the Keeps subscription, you'll get refill reminders so you don't run out, and you'll have access to 24/7 expert support to help you make your hair goals a reality. Now it's true, there's no magical cure for baldness, but you can try and prevent it from happening. Hair loss stops with Keeps. To get 50% off your first order, go to keeps.com/brickscience or click the link in the description. That's KEEPS.com/brickscience. Huge thanks to Keeps for helping men keep their hair and for sponsoring this video. Now let's hurry up and finish the build. All right, the next thing we're gonna build is a Lego pen with 3 different pens on it that'll rotate as you draw. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take these 3 things, put them like this in a circle, and then we're going to invent something that essentially just spins them around while you draw. We use this motor and battery box to control it. We should be able to put those, yes. Check this out, guys. We put this here, and then it always spins no matter what direction. Start the motor. No matter what direction you're drawing, it will always, Whoa. Okay, that particularly might be a bad idea. Wow, that is just horrible. You know what? Forget about the bendy thing. Hey, that's kind of cool. Just have to get all of them to work. Okay, I think they need to be closer together, guys. Do that. Those are a lot closer now. Right. We're getting there. We're gonna put in more. Now we have 6. Check this out. We grab our wheel. Oh, we got a 2. Titan. Here we go. That is awesome. It's like a ton of tiny circles. And look, you can even do it at an angle a bit. That's sick. Yo! And then if you want to make it tighter, you just simply push down. And then you have tighter. Look at that. You got 6 pens in 1 Lego master pen. I'd say this one is useful because you can actually do some pretty cool designs with it. And it was really simple. You just put like 6 pens in it. This is cool. All right, next we're gonna build a Lego tripwire alarm. We're gonna use a Mindstorms EV3 and a button sensor, and that's... We're gonna put this on one end and attach a pin to a string right here. The string will be attached somewhere on the other end, and when someone trips the string, this thing will be released, and it'll go pew, 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 pew. Now, we can program this using our iPad. It's gonna be super simple. Literally, we're just gonna do it. When program starts, forever block right here, wait until released, and then we're going to add a sound block. Now, while we're waiting, this is giving me stress. We're programming on the computer, same thing. We have here a Lego string, which is really simple. It's just a little winch. We need to attach a pin of some sort to this side. Boom. Now we have that tied onto here, like that. So when this is yanked or tripped, it will go doing with that sound effect specifically. Attach this to this. Nice. If we have this on one side of the door, we have this over here, and someone walks by, that'll totally work, guys. There's no doubt. There's a little bit of doubt.
Okay, guys, check this out. I'm gonna put this here, set it up like that. Okay, here we go.
Hey, Ella, you have a minute?
Do you like my alarm?
I was like, what was that?
Hey, it actually worked.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. It does work, so I'd say that's definitely worth making. Let's go build the next one. You know what? I bet you guys have a problem. When you listen to earbuds, they sound so great. You take them off and you put them in your pocket and you're like, ah, oh, it's all tangled. I have an idea for a Lego gadget that will actually keep this rolled up, and you can unroll it and then you can twist it to roll it back up. A lot of people have done this. This isn't an original idea, but it's easy to do in Lego, probably. We need a special piece that's about this big with a hole. This is a cool piece. Let's see. What we want to happen is that one end turns and the other end turns too. Now, twist it and it works, probably. That. So now obviously it doesn't do anything. What? We're gonna get this, okay? We are. Just throw those there.
That's the one, guys. I can feel it.
Just grab your earbuds like that. Put it in your pocket. It's pretty bulky. And there you go. You can listen to earbuds. Yeah, this one's trash. Don't do this one. This was a bad idea for a gadget. Maybe you guys can design a better one than I could. All right, so my idea for the next contraption is to use this lens, which is like a super good magnifying lens, and these glasses right here, and build something on the side that will kind of flip in like this so you can see stuff really close up and look pretty cool. So that's the next idea.
So first, we need to figure out where this goes.
Probably honestly about there. Now we need to build a cool case for this so it looks better than this.
That looks stupid.
No, that would actually look super cool. Perfect. Look at that. That is awesome, actually.
Pretty much just like that. And then, there we go.
Looks a lot better from the front now. Now, we need to come up with something that'll hold these glasses really tight. So, use this Lego rubber piece like this. We should be able to come up with some sort of a mount. Sits on there like that, and then this thing go like this. And here. Now, attach to this and rest on there like that. It's not far enough over. We can do this. Look, we're just gonna add a few more pieces. Hey, hey, look at that, guys. Dang, do I look good or what? This actually works really good. Dang, this is so sick. See the microscopic stuff? Look at that, you can totally see the details of everything. Super, super well. That's the table. There's the Lego brick. These glasses are literally so cool. I'd say that's definitely useful, and it doesn't look too stupid either. This one, you pop it up, and it's not that bad. You just pop it out of sight. I'd say this is definitely super sick. All right, so the next gadget idea I have is a automatic phone swiper. So if you're on like social media or whatever, you're on Instagram, you wanna get through all those stories, you just press it and it goes and it just swipes. I think it'd be pretty useful, unless it's not. So here's how we're gonna do it. We're gonna need a bit of aluminum foil and a wire like this. We're gonna tape this to the foil, tape that to the arm, and let's build up a super quick mechanism that will essentially just make this motion. Like that, put it on that side, put it on there, put that on there. Now, what we got? That's almost it. Yes. That could work, guys. We just have to hold it at this angle specifically. Let's mount this at the angle that it was working. Replace this up here with a motor. Beautiful. That is gonna swipe through so many Instagram stories. People are gonna be like, I thought you cared about me. Nah. Just kidding. Oh, it doesn't have It doesn't have any electricity on it. Okay, so that's where the foil comes in. We're gonna wrap this around this, tape this to it, and then hold the other end, and then it'll pretty much think that this is our finger. Okay, here we go, this is it. Oh no, I clicked an ad.
Yeah, I think this actually works.
Check it out, guys. I am scrolling through so many stories. I'm blurring this out just for people's privacy, by the way. This is actually working really, really well. Except sometimes it scrolls backwards. I wonder if you can like scroll down. It's literally scrolling through the entire Instagram. Oh, it's reached the bottom. Oh, nope, it's going still.
Guys, I'd say this is definitely worth it if you're super lame and just don't like looking at what your friends post. There's probably a practical use, but just like care about people. Gosh. Guys, comment down below which one of these Lego gadgets was your favorite. Huge thanks to Keeps for sponsoring this video. Check out their link down in the description. Check out this video if you want to see when I built the world's strongest Lego L motor. Now what am I gonna do with all these?